Good morning, everyone. My name is Adarsh Shankar, third year POS graduate resident, JJM Medical College. The title of my paper is Role of the Multiplanar Reconstruction Imaging and the Three-Dimensional Computed Tomography Imaging and Diagnosing Cranial and the Facial Fractures. Name and the objective of the study, the various injuries caused by the ferocity head and the facial regions being the most commonly affected region, involvement of this region may lead to life-threatening situation, which includes the profuse blood loss, soft tissue swelling, lacerations, and the pain. Skull fracture, also known as the cranial fracture, can occur in road traffic accident as well as sports and any other injuries. Fracture to the skull can occur in any region on the skull. All brain injuries, including the traumatic brain injuries, subdural hematoma, epidural or the extradural hematoma, or the traumatic intercerebral hematoma, or the contusions. The role of brain radiography in assessing the facial traumas has declined over the years, since X-rays are sensitive to the cranial wall fracture but are insensitive to the skull-based fracture, as it does not provide sufficient information regarding the anatomic details. The role of MRI in trauma is to assess the soft tissue injury, since it has good soft tissue contrast and also helps in aiding the assessing the patients with the neurographic deficiencies, but is not useful as compared to the CT in the evaluation of the bony pathologies. The role of multiplanar reconstruction and the 3D reconstruction of the multi-detector computed tomography in the musculoskeletal system is of tremendous advantage in the traumatic injuries, and the results of the brain radiography to answer the doubts of the surgeons regarding the satisfactory alignment of the complex fracture. Small structures that are not well seen with the conventional CT imaging can be clearly depicted using the multiplanar reconstruction and the 3D overlapping reconstruction at the small intervals. Reformatted images can provide complementary information about the various conditions, including the congenital malformation, vascular anomalies, and the trauma involving the cranial and the facial bones. Coming to the materials and the methodology of the study, 100 patients with the clinical history and the examination findings of the cranial and the facial fractures from the JJM Medical College who were referred to the CT to the Department of the Radiology were included in the study. 100 patients fulfilling the criteria were included in the study. The average age taken was from 20 to 24 years. The patient was scanned in a GECT machine with appropriate brain and facial protocols with a bone and soft tissue reconstruction. During the study, proper instructions were given to the patients and protective measures such as the lead aprons were used to cover the patient's body to minimize the radiation dose to the patient. Throughout the procedure, vitals were monitored. Factors that were assessed include airline, simple and displaced, comminuted, and the simple displaced fracture. The images obtained were subjected to the radiologic analysis and the interpretation. The parameters for KVP were 100 to 120 and the MS was around 3 to 300 to 350. Slice thickness was 5 mm and the field of vision was 18 to 22 and the scan length was 250 to 300 mm. Coming to the inclusion criteria, traumatic cranial and the facial fractures were included. Pregnant and lactating women and non-traumatic patients were excluded for the study. Coming to the discussion, plane radiography is the initial imaging modality in the trauma patients, but since it cannot provide adequate information regarding the internal and the skull-based anatomy, its significance in assessing the cranial and the facial fracture trauma has declined. Moreover, in the patient with the multiple traumas, especially the involving the cranial and the facial fracture, there may be life-threatening consequences while positioning the patient, since its role is limited. Depressed fracture not in the right parietal bone, impinging on the underlying brain parenchyma. Segmental fractures noted in the inner table of the right frontal bone or frontal sinus, resulting in the large defect. The evaluation of the fractures, multiplanar reconstruction, and the 3D sequences were widely used for the successful identification of the fracture site. This is especially true for the fractures of the cranial and the facial region. This is because these structures are located and done in the transverse plane, but trauma images can provide false positive images since adjacent regions easily overlap. Hence, this produces a false image, thereby making the diagnosis difficult. However, in a wider context, transverse imaging is useful as a method of visualization of the anatomical elements perpendicular to the examined brain. A good example would be the evaluation of the anterior and the lateral walls of the maxilla sinus and the orbital bones. The high sensitivity in diagnosing fractures of the maxilla, frontal, and the nasal bone was relieved by the multiplanar reconstruction. It was noted that in the imaging of the thin and delicate bone structures, such as the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone, orbital floor, and in some cases also the anterior wall of the maxillary sinus, 3D reconstruction were less useful than the multiplanar reconstruction. The use of 3D reconstruction in those areas often produces a false positive image, suggestive of the inexistent holes that are difficult or impossible to differentiate from the fractures. In 3D reconstruction cannot be used as a only imaging method in the visualization of the fracture. When comparing the results of the imaging with the use of the direct acquisition of the raw data with the 3D reconstruction, it is also worth noticing the susceptibility to artifacts, that is, occurrence of the false image elements that do not exist in real day. may follow from the study protocol only. For example, if the size thickness is too thick during the multidisciplinary reconstruction, a staged up artifact appears. Often, et al. Conducted a study in which it was proved that the acquisition of the multi-detector computed tomography with slice thickness of 2.5 mm and slice thickness less than 1.5 mm is enough to avoid the staged up artifacts in the multidisciplinary reconstruction. Furthermore, in the visualization of the free dislocated fissure segment, multidisciplinary reconstruction turned out to be more successful in the assessment of the post-traumatic lesions involving the orbit and the maxillary sinuses. Three-dimensional reconstruction have also turned out to be of the limited utility not only in the above discussed group of symptoms, but also in the imaging of the ethmoid bones. However, it was successful in visualizing the free bone chips within the condylar process branches and the body of the mandible, anterior wall of the frontal sinus, zygomatic arch, zygomatic bones, and the nasal bones. It also provided useful in the imaging of the trifold fractures. The technique of the 3D reconstruction also turned out to be useful also in the evaluation of the fracture with the high number and the extent of the dislocation of the bone chips. Among all the applied techniques of the presentation and the reconstruction of the CT images, the 3D option allows for a very prescribed reconstruction of the post-traumatic anatomical relation in contrast to the transverse and the multiplanar imaging. This is a minimally displaced fracture in the right parietal and the temporal bones well depicted in the coronal reformated CT image. On the sagittal reformated CT image shows the fracture line. This is the axial CT image showing the depressed fracture. This is the multiplanar CT image is well demonstrating the depressed fracture in the right parietal and the temporal bones and full extent of the fracture. Coming to the results of the present study reveal that compared to the four types of fracture, simple and displaced was found to be the most frequently occurring one, wherein in multiplanar reconstruction was found to be more detective for the fracture compared to the multiplanar reconstruction and 3D multiplanar planar reconstruction axial and the 3D multiplanar reconstruction and axial. Statistically, analysis was carried out using the formula and software t-test. This is the above bar graph showing that in my study, simple undisplaced fracture were the most common one sustained. This graph shows that in my study, multiplanar reconstruction imaging was most accurate means of detecting the canal and the facial factors compared to the other mode of study. Coming to the conclusion, this study has highlighted the usefulness of the multiplanar reconstruction technique as imaging tool in the enabling the accurate localization of the P bone fragments and assessing the degree of the displacement and thus helping the reduce the recurrent exposures. These are my references. Thank you.